What's poppin', y'all? It's your boy Frankie. Welcome back to my humble home for another edition of Frankie's Faves, a series where I share with you my favorite experiences straight out of my journal. Today, we're going to get off the old beaten path and we're gonna actually do a Q&A at the Pursuit of Nana in Manila, the Philippines.
Whoa,
that's far. Okay. Have you ever wanted to be with someone, but you don't let your shield down because you don't like yourself enough? I keep on holding back because I feel like he won't like me once he gets closer. Such a fantastic question. Thoughts in my own head. I feel like you just got in my head and it spoke for me. I will say the following. This reminds me of a paragraph or an exchange in The Velveteen Rabbit. It goes like this. The characters, the rabbit and a horse, their toys, are having a discussion about what constitutes being real and how you are made to be real. And the following takes place. Real isn't how you are made, said the skinned horse. It's a thing that happens to you. When a child loves you for a long, long time, not just to play with, but really loves you, then you become real. Does it hurt? Asked the rabbit. Sometimes, said the skin horse, for he was always truthful. When you are real, you don't mind being hurt. Does it happen all at once, like being wound up? He asked. Or bit by bit. It doesn't happen all at once, said the skin horse. You become. It takes a long time. That's why it doesn't often happen to people who break easily, or have sharp edges, or have to be carefully kept. Generally, by the time you are real, most of your hair has been loved off. And your eyes dropped out, and you get loose in the joints and very shabby. But once you are real, you can't be ugly, except to people who don't understand you. My dear at the Pursuit of Nana in Manila, you need to be you, unapologetically and unafraid. You are wonderfully and beautifully made. Anybody who thinks that you are not beautiful lacks the capacity to understand your beautiful intricacies. Do not shrink yourself to appease others. Do not shrink yourselves so that somebody else's eye is not offended. You, my dear, are wonderfully and beautifully made. And the people who may consider you ugly are people who do not have the capacity to understand you. And that is not about you. That's about them. You be you. It's the best gift you can give to yourself and to the world. Such a good question. Question from @Jolie_Coyour. Not sure if I'm pronouncing that right. That could be English or French. Not sure. She's in Dallas, Texas, and she asks two questions. What was the first thing you watched on Disney Plus, and why didn't you send me your login? Okay, so the first thing I watched on Disney Plus was Pinocchio. Loved, loved, loved that movie. I grew up in a Hispanic household, so when we were growing up, I didn't have access to all the Disney classics. So watching these stories now, I understand what people were talking about when we were growing up, because I didn't back then. And I love Pinocchio. My favorite scene in Pinocchio is when that villain guy is, I think his name is the Cartman or something like that. He says to the other villain, he says, I'm collecting stupid little boys. And then the other villain looks at him like, stupid little boys? And he says, stupid little boys, because basically it's my dating life. So I loved it. Why haven't I sent you my login information? Okay, first of all, how dare you? Okay, I am a Catholic, honest man, and I do not cheat the system. Okay, last time I broke the law was November 7th, 2017. Haven't done it since. So how dare, okay, I did do it last summer. I ran a red light and I got a ticket, which reminds me I haven't done my defensive driving course. Thank you at Jolie Co. Error for reminding me that I am a criminal. At Daniela Flame in San Francisco, California, wants to know, what is one of the frequent misconceptions about the recovery process for alcoholism? Such a fantastic question. I'm gonna answer it by sharing with you my misconception of it. You see, I thought when I went into recovery that the fun was over. I thought that I would never have fun again, that was it, right? That I was going to become an old grandpa at home that never got out and did anything. Nothing could be further from the truth. I have so much fun now that I didn't even know I could have. One, I get to be present in everything. As a sober man, I get to remember everything because I was the type of alcoholic that always drank to blackout. So I get to be present for everything. That, to me, is amazing. Second, I get to spend time with myself, right? So on Friday nights, Saturday nights, I am often at home alone with a book, in pajamas, with a Coca-Cola and some very, very unhealthy snacks, and I'm having time for myself after a arduous week of fitness and work and, you know, just personal growth. So I think that the misconception is that fun is over, but I believe that nothing could be further from the truth. I believe that truly the fun for me began more completely once I became sober, once I became present, once I became active in my own life, really is what it was.